Having reviewed the mitochondrial electron carriers in the last video, we're set to look at the process of oxidative phosphorylation in more detail. To start, we're going to look at the electron transport chain through which electrons from NADH and QH2 are passed from one electron carrier to another and ultimately to molecular oxygen. The general process is pictured in this diagram. NADH and QH2, which are produced in the citric acid cycle, give electrons to proteins in the electron transport chain. To keep the diagram simple, the entire electron transport chain is shown as this black shape here. The electrons ultimately end up producing molecular oxygen, which becomes water. The NAD plus and Q are now available to pick up more electrons from this citric acid cycle. The process of electron transport is energetically favorable. The energy released from movement of electrons from one carrier to another is used to move protons or hydrogen ions across the inner mitochondrial membrane from the matrix to the intermembrane space. This results in an electrochemical proton gradient across the membrane, which is a form of potential energy. So this is the main point of the electron transport chain. The energy from movement of electrons from NADH and QH2 to oxygen is used to generate an electrochemical gradient across the inner mitochondrial membrane. This diagram shows in more detail the process of moving electrons from NADH to oxygen. The gray shapes represent large protein complexes embedded in the inner mitochondrial membrane. NADH gives electrons to cofactors in the first complex, complex 1, which ultimately moves them to coenzyme Q in the membrane. During this process, complex 1 pumps some protons out of the matrix. The reduced coenzyme Q moves to complex 3, which accepts electrons and passes them to cytochrome C, which is a peripheral membrane protein associated with the inner mitochondrial membrane. Complex 3 also pumps some protons out of the matrix. Cytochrome C takes electrons to complex 4, which accepts electrons and transfers them to molecular oxygen to make water. Again, the energy from electron transport is used to move protons from the matrix to the intermembrane space. Note that it takes 4 electrons to reduce one O2 molecule to 2 water molecules. Since each NADH carries 2 electrons, you need 2 NADH molecules to reduce one O2 molecule. This diagram depicts the changes in Gibbs free energy at each of these steps. The scale on the left shows reduction potential with low values on the top and higher values towards the bottom. For this course, you don't need to worry about calculations involving reduction potential. You should just be aware that the higher the reduction potential, the greater the affinity for electrons. So you can see that electrons pass from one carrier to another in a defined order of increasing electron affinity. Each step has a strongly negative delta G value, providing enough energy to do the work of pumping protons out of the mitochondrial matrix. We'll look at each of these complexes in turn, starting with complex 1. Complex 1 is also called NADH dehydrogenase. NADH binds to a site on the matrix side of the membrane and gives up its electrons to electron-carrying cofactors embedded in complex 1. These include a flavin here and numerous iron sulfur centers. Ultimately, the electrons are acquired by coenzyme Q in the inner mitochondrial membrane. The energy from this process is used to move 4 protons from the matrix to the intermembrane space. Note that NADH releases 1 proton when it loses its 2 electrons, and coenzyme Q gains 2 protons when it gains the 2 electrons. Overall, the reaction catalyzed by NADH is shown here. 5 protons are removed from the matrix and 4 are added to the intermembrane space. For the test, you do not need to remember which electron carriers are in which complex, and you do not need to memorize the stoichiometry of the reaction of each complex. In the next video, I'll describe what happens to the electrons from QH2 when this molecule diffuses away from complex 1 and encounters complex 3.